Don't worry about it. Let's keep going.
So first, I'm going to use bonus action to cast Healing Word on Lazarus.
All right.
Ooh.
For that much. And can I see the drow from here?
Yes, you can.
I don't know it's a drow, but...
The dark elf.
You can see it.
Okay, I'm going to cast Hold Person on it.
Hey, a hold person is absolutely evil.
So it's got to make a wisdom save or else be paralyzed.
Oh yeah, they fall.
Well, it's they're literally like something's tying them up and they just kind of fall over. Now it's a wisdom save, you say?
Yeah, I think it would also be 13, just like Sacred Flame is.
Yep.
Oh no. Failure.
So anyone who attacks her within 5 feet can crit her.
Because she's paralyzed?
Yep.
Here comes the onslaught.
And that's the end of my turn.
What a turn. What a turn.
All right. It'd be the wolf's turn. You see the big guy go get him back.
Go get him back.
Where is the wolf? 8 creatures. The wolf. He's going to try to bite your ankle. Okay. Your AC is not 22, so he hits you.
I'm guessing I don't have Sanctuary up.
You then did you re-up it? That's something
I don't remember.
I don't believe you ever
did. I
don't
think you said it.
Yeah, I don't think you did, but that would have been.
I don't recall you ever doing so.
That would have been sweet. Perfect.
I thought I did that with between every encounter, but I don't know if I've been holding my mic down for it or not.
Pay no attention to those two going. Save or not. Okay, I'll roll the save anyway. What was the save?
11.
No, but what was the save? What was it?
It's wisdom.
Wisdom save. If he has +1 wisdom. What was it? And it was 12?
It's 11.
Well, he got a 14.
Yay, the dog is wise.
Dog has 12 wisdom. Dog bites you in the ankle for 8 damage.
Ow.
Now you need to make a strength saving throw.
Oh no. He's taking you down.
It is pulling on your ankle rather harshly.
Strength saving throw. But
you manage to pull your ankle out of the wolf's mouth and you don't fall over.
Got it.
All right. His turn. He has a big old morning star, by the way.
Oh boy.
Kronk.
Never seen a bugbear without one.
He swings down his Morningstar upon you.
Well, this is gonna suck.
Well, he has to make a wisdom save.
Yep.
What was it? 11, 12?
It was 11.
He succeeds.
Okay. They're both immune to it. They don't have to roll again.
And his roll is a 19.
Okay.
And you take 8 damage from his Morning Star.
Got it.
He says, "You let go of my prisoner." And it's Blackjack's turn.
All right, Blackjack. Swiftly, it's gonna go this way. He taps Lazarus on the back and says, "You could do this." And then he goes back this way.
Did you just inspire me, or?
Yes, you are now heroic.
It's bardic inspiration.
No, it's heroism.
It wasn't.
Although that's also a good idea, but I can do bardic inspiration from far away.
Oh, that's right.
This is a total spell. Basically, until the spell ends, you are immune to being frightened, and you gain 2 temporary hit points at the beginning of each of your turns.
Right. The reason I thought you was bardic inspiration is because you said he was inspired.
Yes, but he is now heroically inspired. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And if I can see him, I say... Oh, I don't know.
You can see.
Yeah, but I don't know. My character does not know that, so I can't do it. As part of my action, I'm whipping out one of my healing potions. Turn done.
All right, Lazarus.
So you can only coup de grace an incapacitated person, right?
Paralyzed is not... Is paralyzed incapacitated?
It says that they are incapacitated.
Then yes.
I'm a coup de grace. And that's a critical hit.
Yay!
Wait, I think they have to be helpless, not incapacitated.
I have no idea.
I don't see helpless as a condition.
Do you see coup de grace as an action?
No, but Chris made a special rule for it.
When did I do that?
You said that you were going to add it, and then you were going to make them make a con check and shit. Remember?
If I said that, it was months ago.
Con check and shit.
It was like, not months, like a month. But whatever, she takes that much damage.
It's like, I wasn't aware there was a coup de grace in 5e.
There's something.
She takes that much damage.
Well, the coup de grace really is just a critical automatic.
Yeah.
In 4E, a coup de grace is if when you critical hit something and you deal X amount of damage, it may instantly die.
If you dealt more than their total health.
I think it's half of their health.
That's what I meant.
So well, say, if you did more than total their health, then yeah, they're gone.
I'm going to just walk past her. Because she can't do shit right now. And nope. She's also my mark.
I believe she gets a save on her turn.
On her turn, probably.
Does it specify end of turn?
Let me check real quick. At the end of each of its turns, the target can make another wisdom saving throw.
As I said, that's why I asked. Because some of them say at the beginning, or some of them say at the end.
Yeah, it says at the end of each of its turns.
Okay, so is that your whole turn, Lazarus?
Yeah, I just moved past her and I marked her.
Well, she's going to try to save against being paralyzed, I think. though she might be able to actually do something while... I need to check the condition real quick.
It says that they are incapacitated, and they cannot take actions or reactions.
Makes no sense. If an action does not require movement, why could they not do it?
Well, they can't talk either, or speak.
What if it's something that doesn't require movement of any kind?
I don't know. You're the DM.
I think she could do this, even if she is paralyzed.
Then let her do it.
Okay, she's going to pick a save. What kind of save was this again? Wisdom?
Wisdom. 13 DC.
She does not save. She's still paralyzed.
Cool.
Okay, Zhang.
So. Okay, I have a really important turn. So I'm going to spend a key point, first of all. I'm going to actually move up here, and I drop the dwarf behind me against the wall.
Mm-hmm.
And I have my staff. I'm going to attack the wolf first. Pray to God I hit.
Well, dang it, wrong one. You hit.
Okay, I bludgeoned the wolf for a lot.
Oh no. You kill the wolf.
Yeah, fuck that wolf. After I kill the wolf for a lot, I basically take the stabbed body of the wolf and I sling it at the bugbear for my unarmed strike.
Wait, you do what now?
I staff it and I'm just role playing. Don't even worry about it. I'm using my unarmed strike on the bugbear.
It does not work.
Okay, and then I heal myself.
All right. Then it's Albert's turn.
I will move. And bugbears don't count as humanoids, right?
No, bugbears are humanoid.
Oh. Then I'll cast Hold Person on him as well.
Like a Sturge is not humanoid.
Yeah,
an owlbear is not humanoid.
I wasn't sure if goblinoids counted as humanoids or if they were their own thing.
But... bugbears, actually, most goblinoids are humanoid.
Okay.
Actually. I can't remember if goblins themselves are or not, though.
Humanoid generally just means two arms, two legs, one head. Or just two arms and two legs.
Yeah, goblins are small humanoids.
Alright. He's got to make a wisdom save of 13.
This would be interesting if Hold Person saves the day. He fails?
That'll be the end of my turn, then.
Well, it's his turn. He can't do anything. He'll just try to save. He only has 11 wisdom. Well, I don't think a 2 is going to cut it. So, Blackjack... I have some poor news for you, caster of spells.
What's the poor news?
Well, you're not the caster of spells I meant, but okay. Hold person is a concentration spell.
Oh, okay. So.
So you'd have to
cast that, or well, concentration on the other one.
Oh well, if you, as far as I know, you can't concentrate on two things at once. But I'll look real quick.
No, you can't cast with two concentrations.
I mean, if he just used his action to concentrate on both, that'd probably be a thing.
But it's not. I don't know.
I'm looking. You can do your turn.
Whose turn?
Well, next was the bugbear's turn, wasn't it? And whether or not I can hold him is pretty dependent on this.
Okay. The way it is you can only cast one spell that requires concentration at a time. You can cast other spells that do not, but you can only concentrate on one spell at once.
Oh, but you're saying it's the same spell.
No, but it is technically another spell that requires concentration.
Yeah, okay. So I couldn't even cast it on him then?
Well, if you did, you would automatically lose concentration on the other one, and that hold person effect would end immediately.
All right. Is it cool if instead of that, I just cast Guiding Bolt on him?
Yes, that's just fine.
Okay.
Is that an attack, or is it a save?
That's an attack. And probably a missed one.
Yes.
All right, now it's the end of my turn.
And then it would be his turn, and he's not held. And he's going to try to pummel you into the ground, Zane.
Okay, Dad.
And he pummels the wall next to you.
Oh, thank God.
Blackjack.
Blackjack continues his jazz. He runs over the potion.
Yeah, it is an action.
Yeah, that's my turn.
Okay.
What did you do?
Were you giving it to him or feeding it to him?
I'm administering it.
You're administering it. Then you immediately get 2d4 plus something.
Me?
No, he does, because he drank, because you administered it to him.
Who's he?
You.
I no, don't.
The dwarf.
Yeah.
Oh, the dwarf. Then the dwarf immediately gets the 2d4.
Yes.
You just said him.
No, I said the dwarf.
I said him. I confused myself.
Oh, okay. Fair enough.
He's still unconscious, but he obviously is not dying.
Cool.
Try to like tap him on the face to wake him up, because now he's like super healed.
He's still unconscious.
That's lame. My turn's done.
All right, Lazarus.
Well, seeing as how she's currently paralyzed, 1, 2, 3, 4. I get the position to flank and stab him in the back. Does that hit his AC?
What? You stabbed the door frame.
Did you roll twice?
Yeah.
With advantage, and his total was a 14. It's not enough.
What does heroism give me again?
It gives you 2 temporary hit points at the start of each of your turn. And you cannot be frightened.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the immune to frightened is actually the better part of that spell.
What? No, it's not.
Yeah, it is. You face things that automatically frighten you every turn. That spell keeps it from happening.
Well, that's the end of that.
C30 fright check. Okay, so then back to the top. And gonna try to save. Gonna work. Zang.
Zing turn. Okay. Wait a minute. I think I'm an idiot. Hang on.
Not gonna disagree too much with
you. Never mind, I'm not an idiot. I'm fine. I'm just second guessing myself too much. Zing is gonna unload on this bugbear. Staff strike first.
God damn it. I think you messed up something there. You need to put a 1. The L1.
There.
There you go. You managed to smack him right across the face.
Pop. And a step on his toe.
Okay.
Oh my god!
You stomp down really hard.
Hang on a second. Hang on a second. Hang on a second. Damn it, I keep forgetting this. What's my ratio for crits?
You add an extra weapon die.
Oh, I think he wants his... Is it 19 and 20? Is that what you're talking about?
No, he gets an extra weapon die if he crits.
I mean, he's a...
Bah!
He's a half-orc.
Oh, that's right. Half-orcs get extra crit dice.
So wait, if you crit normally, do you get an extra die anyway?
Yes, yeah. You just get an extra one.
Add that to it.
It's when you score a critical hit with a melee weapon, you can roll one of the weapon's damage dice one additional time and add it.
Okay. Well, then it would be, the total is those two numbers. It's about one of the shittiest crits I've ever seen, but whatever.
It's alright. You have chopped his health down considerably in one turn.
Cool.
Okay, let's see, that was Zang's turn, so it's Albert's turn.
I'll go for another Guiding Bolt.
That hits.
Ow! Also, the next attack roll made against him gets advantage.
Ow! That does a lot of damage.
Imagine it's not even what average would have been for that spell.
I know, that's a lot! Hey. Well, it's his turn now. He's going to, he's actually going to.
He's stepping away?
He is stepping away.
Let me see what I can do.
So you're making an attack roll on him?
I am, but I already had advantage.
Ah, okay. I think that might still take the advantage from it, because it's just the next attack roll in general.
Actually, can I try and trip him?
Ooh. I'm not sure.
Because, I mean, I'll make the opposed strength check.
I mean, I like the idea, but I'm not sure.
Well, I mean, it's usually like an attack action, and an opportunity attack is an attack. So it's your call.
Yeah, I'm looking for the opportunity attack stuff. So. It doesn't actually specify what an opportunity attack is, other than that it is an attack of opportunity. So I'd say, yeah, you can try to trip him. Oh, well.
He has to make a strength check. I think.
Trip again.
I don't think it's in the player's handbook. I think it's in something they
You know what's in here somewhere.
Tripping is not in the player's handbook. It's something they released.
Oh, that's right. We just decided it was kind of like a shove.
They did tripping and they did not shoving, but they did like a...
No, shove's one that's in the book.
Yeah, but they did one also that's similar to shove, and I think they also did disarm.
Yeah, I'd say a trip is the same thing as a shove as far as checks.
Okay, well, he makes a strength check.
Or an acrobatics check.
Or that.
You know how acrobatic bugbears. And it's contest, and you win.
He falls on his ass, then.
He's still in this square.
Oh, no, he don't.
Of course, he stands back up.
Yeah.
And he turns around and wails on you.
Eh. I still have a mark, though.
Well, he was a little shaken up from the trip, so he missed. Blackjack.
I don't know. Is he prone?
No, he stood back up. He still had movement, so he stood back up. Standing up takes 15 feet of move.
Oh, I guess now's the time, isn't it? Is now the time? Yeah, now's the time. He hears voices in the back of his head. Now's the time.
What the fuck?
Yeah. Let me, do this here. Oh, yeah, one moment.
Now is not the time.
Yeah, now's the time.
I'm scared.
Is it in that same slightly bored tone? Is that what's in his head?
Yeah.
Is it slightly bored? Yeah, now's the time.
Well, it's not a bored tone. It's now's the time. Partially sleepy, partially disappointed, and about to wake back up because he's got to do some stuff here. Let's see here, 5e spells.
My fault you guys are messing. You're the one doing really good tactic stuff.
Yeah, you're... No, this is better than just really good. This is ridiculously hilarious. Like, this is insane balls to the wall. Awesome.
I believe I told Arthur at one point, this module is poorly balanced. It really is.
I don't know what it has to do with anything.
Why, like, in our favor or for them?
Oh, in your favor.
Yeah, I'm not really bored. Let's see here.
Well, it's not to the point where you're literally
he needs
like...
to make a wisdom saving throw of 12.
Oh, the wise bugbear.
The wise bugbear.
So he don't get any bonus. So he rolls a... So he rolls a 1.
Alright, well this is great. So, he's going insane. Alright, so...
So what actually are you doing?
I am causing him 3d6 psychic damage. First of all. Shazam. Second of all, he is moving as far away as his speed allows away from me. And in doing so, this is one of the only spells that does guarantee opportunity attacks.
Oh my god!
Did you just fear him?
They are whispers in his head that are quite dissonant.
What's the name of the spell? Dissonant Whispers?
Yes, one of the only bard-only spells.
Yeah, and it's super...
It's
silly.
It's not super good. It's very,
No, it's silly. That's what it is.
It's pretty situational, I would have to say, but the situation does call for it.
Situational. But if the situational is, like, there, then he's screwed. So, yeah. Go away. Go away.
It's move away from me. Wow.
Yeah, pretty much. Every single character will get an attack.
Well, it's basically, if he fails to save, he's basically feared for one turn. It's the effect.
And he takes up to 18 damage.
Yeah, and you damage him.
Yeah, we're all attacking him, basically. Goodbye.
You're the weakest link.
Yeah, it's basically you get one turn of fear on him. So that is your turn.
Yeah, but a lot of the fear spells don't actually cause opportunity attacks.
That's
the problem. This does. Like the turn undead, that doesn't cause opportunity.
Fear. Attack. Fear does. The spell
does. Anyway, keep it going.
Okay, then it is Lazarus's turn.
Wait, what? No. He's losing his speed away. It's still his turn.
Oh, does he have to do it immediately or on his turn?
Yes, he does it immediately.
Oh.
Yes, well, he does it now.
Okay, there's one.
Wow. I think with combat advantage, right?
Yes, you get combat advantage on that.
Jeez.
So you get to roll the 2d20. Oh, jeez. So how dead is he?
Splat, motherfucker!
No, God. The fear spell, the creature must take the dash action, the safest available route.
There now. He's just going over the table.
Hey, there's another advantage attack right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, do I get to swing at him now?
You get to swing at him when he leaves the last square.
Assuming he's still alive. Right now, Lazarus gets the pump.
I popped him pretty damn good.
With advantage.
Yeah.
Now, is your attack per turn or per round? Is your bonus thingy? Or is it a bonus action on your turn?
Are you asking me? Yes. Hang on a second.
I just don't know if you get to use Flurry of Blows on your off turn or not.
It's not Flurry of Blows. It's when you use the attack action... On your turn. It has to be on my turn.
There you go. On your turn. Get him, Lazarus. Show him the what fur.
Yeah, that hits. That hits. For a fair amount of it. He does not have 2,000 health. There we go.
Per turn.
And...
And then I take a swing at him.
Yeah, unfortunately, you don't get it.
Wait, why doesn't he get it?
Oh, wait, yeah. Well,
he's moving away from him.
No, wait, does he? Why would he get advantage?
Oh, not advantage, no.
I'm just taking a regular swing.
Yeah.
That's what I said. I don't believe he gets advantage. I mean, I was like...
Oh, you said he doesn't get it. And I'm like, I think he gets it. And you just said, you literally said, get it.
Oh, well, oops. I meant advantage.
Oops.
He barely manages to duck below your blow.
Best turn ever. Done. Turn done.
I think they're all dead.
Okay, then it's Lazarus's turn.
That is that elf lady still?
She's still, she right. Still paralyzed.
And he is still concentrating on this.
That is so lame. This is so funny.
I don't know why he's going after the one that's paralyzed, but okay.
Well, he hits her.
Can't do a bunch of damage to her.
Don't kill her. We need to take somebody alive. We need to know what's going on and why they took her.
You can just make it non-lethal damage, I mean.
She has this rather sour look on her face as she's looking at you.
Turn that frown up.
At the end of your turn? Lazarus?
Sorry. That's the end of my turn.
Well, she's going to try to save. She finally saves.
Yay.
But it was the end of her turn. So, Zane, what are you going to do?
She is marked by...
That's fine.
I'm going to do non-lethal damage to her.
Okay. She still has more than half her health, but okay.
Well, let's see how much of that I can take her.
Can I cast that shit again? How many slots do I get?
You hit her. Fair. I say fair amount of damage. Way more than... Oh, yeah, that hits two.
Bonk!
Bonk, chicka bonk, bonk.
Now she's looking really mad at you as well.
Bonkity bonkity bonk, bonk, bonk.
Zing says, just go to sleep, it'll be easier. And ends his...
Okay, Albert.
I cast Guiding Bolt on the bugbear once more.
Nope, uh-oh. That's all my spells. Oh, I've got Jack of All Trades and Song of Rest now.
He ducks underneath your spell.
And that's the end of my turn.
I was not actually where the bugbear was still alive.
Is it?
Oh, yeah. He's
apparently.
That's what I thought. Yeah. He never died.
I thought I saw a skull appear over his head, so...
It did appear, but that was the skull of the spooky.
Oh,
it was a spooky skull.
He is charging towards you, and he is going to smash you with his Morning Star.
Awesome.
What is your AC?
Mine's 14.
He smashes you with his Morningstar.
Okay.
I think it's plus 4. Oh, no. I don't want to do two more damage. It's plus 2. There, you only take 10 damage from me.
Cool. That's fine.
And it's Blackjack's turn.
Blackjack, he's not dead yet.
You need to have a little tiny Asian kid follow you around.
Here comes the sword. Oh, I only rolled once. Let me see if I get a critical hit.
Let's see if you see if you're... Aw.
Close.
Not quite.
My sword comes through the back, and that's all that Zhang sees, is a sword through his back, through his belly.
Doesn't kill him.
But, oh, dang it. He still sees a sword through his belly.
He is barely standing at this point.
My turn is done.
Lazarus?
Well, I'm a cut into this one.
Cut into the what now?
To the drow.
Oh, okay.
Does that hit?
You fail to cut into the drow. The drow smirks at you.
Lord. I'm not sure who I'm more upset with right now, the drow or the bugbear.
And I'm gonna move here.
Thank you.
That's the end of my turn.
And all right.
That was probably an extremely good idea.
It's her turn.
I can't tell if that's sarcasm or not.
No, it's
time to go.
She moved. I slice her.
I hit her in the face.
And I have advantage.
That's why you did that?
No, I also did it to help protect Zhang from dying.
Yeah, and non-lethal damage, of course, is what I'm doing.
Bleh. Both of you hit.
Bleh.
Okay. Her down a small amount. Lazarus takes her down a bit more. And she keeps going.
Oh. So she had way more health than that. Okay.
She just started. What?
I did as much damage as I
could. I tell Albrecht, can you chase her and cast that again?
I'm out of spells and I'm very slow. I'll try my best.
Well, if you're out of spells, then you can't cast it again.
You need to get this bugbear out of the way so I can go after it. Legit. That's just the only way we're going to be able to catch this lady.
Have it the bat?
Just go.
Guys, just a second.
What just happened?
You had to go ahead.
I will also be right back real quick.
Travis found some hard soda he wanted me to try. So I shall try it. Just not yet. Where were we?
She just ran.
Yes, okay, and that is the end of her turn, so it's Zhang's turn.
Zhang, go! Okay, covered.
Zhang goes, and Zhang will be moving as fast as he possibly can after her. What kind of movement speed do I have to work with here?
If you use a key point, you have 16.
I'm at a key point.
Yeah, I was about to say, like, I think he's used all his key points.
Yeah, I have.
Three. You have three, don't you?
And I'm out of them.
That's right, you level three, you'd have three. Yeah, he's used them all.
I've been burning them like crazy, and I haven't had time to rest and recover them.
Oh, yeah. Well, you have eight, and then you can charge your down and attack.
Yeah, so that's one, two... I realize it's going to be an opportunity attack. We'll get to that.
I'm throwing my shield in the way.
One.
You've already done a reaction.
Oh, shit. Yeah, I can only do that if I shield.
Okay, can I charge her from here?
Wait, how far did you move?
8 squares.
Oh, yeah, you can try to charge her from there.
But, go ahead and roll to see if the bugbear actually hits me.
Alright. Yes, yes.
Even with disadvantage?
Oh, I forgot he had disadvantage. Yes, he does, because he rolled 2 16s.
Cool, awesome.
So, damage. You're going to hate me.
That's fine, how much?
He rolled 18 damage.
Okay, then Zing doesn't even go anywhere. He falls flat on his face.
Yeah.
Can you use your bonus action to heal before that?
You mean with all of the health points I have? I mean, I kind of already used all of them.
He's used pretty much everything he has.
Yeah.
Charge after her.
He can't do no charging no more. He's, I believe you're down, aren't you?
Yeah, very.
Okay, so then it would be... Wait, you need to... You have to make a death saving throw.
Got it.
I think it's at the beginning of turns. I think death saving throws at the beginning.
Oh, that's right. They are. Never mind. You don't have to make one.
Cool.
Albert. Thank you for reminding me that, Mike.
I'm going to channel divinity, preserve life on it's any creature in the area, but Zhang specifically. For he gets up to 15 health, but only up until he gets to half what his health is.
Got it. Okay, it's been marked.
And that is my turn.
Okay, then it is Grohl's. He laughs, and then turns around, and tries to smack you with a sword.
Yeah, the one that feared him?
Yeah.
Yeah. Good luck, Chuck.
Tracy.
That's at least 14.
Is it more or less than 17?
No, it's less.
You take 12 damage.
Ooh, zesty. Zesty.
Yeah, he can do a real... He is a bugbear. He can do a lot of damage in one hit. Let's see if this lives up. That is delicious. It's like alcoholic candy. So that was his turn. Well, then it's your turn.
You can get around him.
I don't really see how.
Well, I mean, like, to flank him.
That's not... I'd delay my turn.
Okay. Delay turn.
I point to him and I say, get him from the other side.
Okay, then it's Lazarus.
I can get the other woman.
Yeah, well, it's a little late for that.
I'm going after her.
Teamwork.
Do you have... What kind of armor are you wearing, though?
Armor doesn't impede your speed.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I forgot.
And I charge her ass.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can. If you can get to there, you can charge her.
How do you charge her?
Because you can charge because something has... Well, you might not have heard it, but you can charge. You just don't necessarily get a bunch of bonus for doing so.
I didn't think you could move and charge like you could in... I thought Zeng could simply because he was doing the super cool stuff.
No. Does that hit her?
Yes, that does hit her AC. Do 8 damage. She is not.
She's now marked.
Yes. So how are you charging?
With it is a home rule.
That oh, okay. Nope, no, that's fair. I just
you didn't can know do what the rule was. Yeah, I thought you knew if you didn't know. So.
I'm gonna take my turn now.
Okay, you take your turn now.
Swish, swish. Swish, 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 swish. Swish, 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 swish. Oh, man. That's rough.
The, somehow this guy is avoiding your attack.
Yeah. Ugh. Alright, my turn's done. I'm not looking too hot, I say to the cleric.
Have you, like, used your inspiration?
I don't have inspiration. We've had a rest since then.
You don't lose it.
Oh, you don't?
No.
It doesn't matter. I still had I already had advantage. I was thinking about using it a while ago at something else, but I just...
Inspiration doesn't give you advantage. It gives you an extra d6.
What now?
No, Bardic Inspiration I cannot give myself.
Okay, well, still.
I was talking about just actual inspiration.
Yeah, and I was too. I was talking about actual inspiration too. Turn done.
Okay, then I need the heals. Well, actually, it's the lady's turn again. Away from you.
I'm going to hit her again, this time with advantage. Well.
So?
She takes that much damage.
You'll never guess how much health she has left.
Does she have fucking 1 HP?
It doesn't matter, you can still keep running after her. Run smack, run smack.
You're like, yeah, she can't get away if you keep doing that.
That's what I was gonna do. I was gonna get after her after she killed the bugbear for me so that I could chase her down and shoot. Run, shooting her through the forest.
That's right, because you're faster than she.
I'm not faster.
I wasn't talking to you.
Oh.
Well, we're all faster than her because she has to... She's only making a run action. We're able to make a run and a charge.
Maybe she has a, oh no, I need to get out of here plan.
Maybe she has that plan, but maybe we're gonna stop
I don't
plan. Know.
Maybe you see her. Then you see her pull out a scroll. Use it.
That's convenient.
It is convenient.
Surprise, it's Fireball.
Now, that'd be funny, but no.
It's kind of weird she waited so long to use
it. Yeah, and she used it over there. But I don't even know what she's doing, so...
It is weird that she moved all the way over there to use it.
Yeah, like, just basically just read it the second she's able to move, make actions, and just be like, bye. Fuck.
How you assumes that scroll could be used?
We're only acting off of what we can see right now, so...
Was there a bolt of lightning that struck her and then she disappeared?
No.
I'm out of options on why she had to use it.
Thunderbolt of lightning, very, very frightening, disappear. Galileo.
I will say that her disappearing reminded you of someone else disappearing.
Yeah, I figured. Well, that's the end of her turn. Who's up?
Let's see, that was the end of her turn. It is Zing's turn.
Can I do anything other than just stand up?
Stand up? No. Yeah, stand up is only like 10 or 15 movement.
Stand up is 15 movement.
Oh,
yeah.
Sweet.
Get all over here, slamming the jam. Welcome.
All right, well, I joined the space.
All you see is a bugbear going, oh, no. Oh, no, no, no.
Not him, not him.
It was the bugbear is just kind of looking around like, where the fuck did she go?
All right, well, I don't hit him with that one.
Dodge number one. Okay, Zang's turn, so it's Albrecht's turn. Oh, wait, no, wait, that was dodge number one. Oh, that's dodge number two.
Lord. All right, well, at least I got to attack him.
Good try.
All right, then it's Albrecht's turn.
I also attack him.
Will that be dodge number three?
It will be.
Yes, dodge number three!
Wait, was that with advantage?
Oh no, roll again. Roll
yeah,
again.
you got flanking.
It is still dodge number three.
That's dodge number four.
It's Grohl's turn now. Oh, sorry, you don't know his.
Yeah, we do.
Who told you his name?
The little goblin fucker.
Oh, that's right, the goblin did tell you. I don't think he has any special actions.
Plot.
He does not have a spin to win. You're so lucky. It's pop, pop, pop. Oh, all three of you are down. No. But he's going to try to knock Zang back down again.
That's not going to be too easy.
Said he's going to try.
I said it's not going to be too easy.
Tracy.
14.
See if he knocks you down. Oh. He hates you so much.
That's fine. How much damage?
It's 18 again.
Okay, bye.
Back down he goes. I swear, 18.
So, my turn?
It's Blackjack's turn.
I thought he held
pokety, pokety,
after
poke,
me.
Pokety poke. You poke. But do you poke him for enough?
Pokety pokety poke poke.
Yes,
poke,
you poke him for enough. He collapses.
Poke. Ah, I say.
Oh no. Ross.
What?
That video.
Yeah, it's pretty much today in a nutshell.
That's pretty much what just happened.
Hey, plot has to blot. That has to do that.
What does that have? I don't understand that, but okay. I know nothing, and I need to go to bed. Block.
That's a song.
Yeah, so...
I get here.
Ta-da, you guys...
Spare the dying on Zang.
Hey!
He stabilized. I heal him.
I wake up. I sit up. I go,
You get that much hit points.
Zing says, and decides to start meditating. So, did you catch the crazy lady in the woods?
No, she teleported away with a scroll. What
the fuck? Who was that? We need to find that out. She
was a drow.
Okay, well, that actually is kind of interesting, but, papers, please. Are there any papers explaining who this lady is? Check the bugbear. Check the wolves. I don't know.
I'ma check under the bed.
I checked the bugbear.
I approach the dwarf and make sure, like, try and assess his health, see how he's doing. Would that be a medicine check?
Wait, what are you trying to do?
The dwarf we just rescued, I'm making sure he's okay. We just found him unconscious on the floor.
At this point, it's pretty obvious he is unconscious, but he's just unconscious. He won't suffer anything more. After some time, he'll probably wake up. So you guys are searching for stuff.
Yeah, I'm checking bug.
You say you're switching, you're checking under the bed?
Yep.
Okay, under his bed, there is a stitched leather sack.
Huh.
Some gold and silver. Some potions of healing, and a map.
I look at it. Well, I take everything out and look at the map. Try and make heads or tails of it.
You can tell that it's leading somewhere into the mountains to a little thing that looks kind of like a cave.
Huh. Okay. Well, I'll count up the gold then. How much?
It is 220 silver, 160 gold, 3 potions of healing.
Okay. All right. Let's go and see if Gundren's okay.
He's unconscious. He looked fine when I last checked him.
Does he still have, like, any wounds or visible wounds?
Nope. He's basically in a sleep right now. But it's like an unconscious. Kind of like a coma, but it's not real.
Would smelling salts wake him up?
You can. Them, do you have?
Would I have them in a healer's kit?
Yes, actually, you would.
I break some smelling salts and try and get them up.
Roll a
medicine check. Chris, you there?
Yes, I'm still here.
He said roll a...
Roll a medicine check.
Advantage, any bonuses?
Just the check. He wakes up. He sputters a bit and says, oh.
Hey there. How you been?
Jerks away from you, and then he realizes who you are. Says, oh, it's you.
And I'm covered in blood and...
Yeah. He jerked away. He didn't, you know, like...
He didn't recognize me covered in blood. Yet.
Zing looks over the dwarf and goes, hi.
Hi. What happened? Where's the bugbear? Where's...
I think he's either unconscious or dead. And the drow got away with it, a scroll.
Hey, Gundren. Hey, Gundren.
Hmm?
Look what I got. And I waved the glass staff at him.
I don't think he knows who that is.
He might. It'd be funny.
He does, actually. He's like, how did you get that?
Apparently leading a gang of ne'er-do-wells, and we kicked him out, and now he's facing the law in, I think, Neverwinter?
Oh. Zing not.
Or so, Waterdeep.
I guess I'm the keeper of the glass staff now. How Whoa. Funny things are. How interesting fate is.
Wait, can I see that?
Yeah, sure. And he hands over the glass staff.
You see him examining it very closely. He has a slightly worried look on his face. After a few minutes, he hands it back and says, well, at least you aren't a spellcaster. That would have been a doozy.
What would happen if I was a spellcaster?
You would have found out the hard way that staff is damaged.
You mean damaged for the purposes of spellcasting?
Yes. As in, if spells were you tried to cast one of its spells, it would probably be very violent.
Zing squints one eye, and he just simply states, I've been using it to hit things.
That would probably work.
Right. Oh.
Magic, so you can hit stuff pretty hard with it.
Oh, hey, Gundren, I found a map.
Map, and he starts checking his pockets. Map. Show me the map.
I show him the map.
And then he pulls a map out of something out of his pocket and opens it up. It looks almost identical, except it has Dwarven writing all over it.
Yeah, hey, I can understand that. It
doesn't have Dwarven on it. Well, you see, you can see next to where that little cave opening is on Gundren's map, it says Wave Echo Cave.
Oh. You did have a map for that. Huh.
Yes, and that's why he kidnapped me, because they wanted to figure out how to get there. I had the map. I wouldn't give it to them. Granted, I hid it on myself in such a manner that they couldn't find it on me. I'm not sure how he got this map, though.
Zing tries hard not to smile when he says that.
Huh. Well, I think we've cleared everything out here. I mean, there's like a supply tower that probably wouldn't be bad to raid. But we have the cart here, so we can take you back to Phandalin.
But why do I need to go back to Phandalin?
Okay, we can take you to your brothers, wherever they are right now.
Well, from what I heard, I'm not sure where my brothers are, or even if they're alive.
Oh.
They said they've been chasing them, because they knew that my brothers knew as well. I fear that they may have been taken care of.
Well, that is a very depressing thought. If it is the case, I am sorry for your loss. On the other hand, if they're alive, you'll have a very happy reunion.
Well, the thing is if they're alive, they would have made their way to the cave, because they knew that no one knows where that cave is. So our best bet to find them would be to go to the cave.
Is to make a mad dash for that cave. Okay.
However, I don't know if I'm any of us are really in shape to go to the cave right now.
I'm okay. I mean, I could go for, like, lunch or something, but otherwise I'm pretty good.
You are covered in someone.
I'm completely exhausted, personally.
I mean, yeah, I'm covered in someone, but, I mean, the job calls.
Physically, I keep going, but all these spells have been exhausting. I need a rest.
Well, I guess this room would probably be the safest room here. Well, the bugbear's room, I guess.
Probably.
I mean, the doors have some barricades on them. I mean,
where's the cave in relation to Phandalin?
I think I have them just of that. In reference to Phandalin, it's actually about 10 miles east. Well, it's out of the foothills and into the mountains, but not too far.
Well, if we already have to go kind of towards Phandalin anyways, we could just leave here and head towards Phandalin.
Might be a little faster, but we'd be traveling on the roads, and if anyone was looking for us, that's where they'd look.
Oh. It's really up to you, okay.
I'm just worried about safety here, because if we travel on the roads, I know the goblins that were here, there's other goblins out there that will come back here after some time.
Why don't we take, like, a lunch break, and then we head towards and get on the road towards Phandalin?
That would probably be best, at least to get out of here. Now, we don't need to stay here for very long, but if we go back to Phandalin, I don't know if Phandalin will be safe. Because we would be there.
Well, we'd be there, so we'd also be able to help, but Phandalin has a pretty formidable force if they want to, and I mean...
What force?
Okay, not formidable, but I mean...
They don't have a militia or anything. The most formidable people there was that gang that you killed.
And we didn't kill all of them. We didn't kill all of them.
And what did the rest do? Did they stay and fight to the death?
No, we scared the shit out of them.
Yeah, they ran.
They ran away.
They would be able to fight these goblins. People like that bugbear.
Actually, we have basically taken the power out of a town by running all those bands away. Unfortunate side effect.
If they
did sort of ask for it.
We would be putting them in danger.
Well, Gundren, I think we should just leave this place at least, because someone did escape that, do you know who that drow lady was? Sorry.
I do not know her name. It was never spoken.
Okay. She got away, and she might have told...
She was the mastermind behind the place.
Okay.
That bugbear was merely her pawn.
Alright, well, that worries me that she got away. I think we should leave this place immediately before she sends reinforcements to deal with us still being here.
That sounds like a decent enough idea.
You didn't go into the South Tower.
We did not. We came straight back here.
Good. Don't go into the South
Tower. Is that the one with the supplies?
Who told you there are supplies in there? There's an owlbear.
What?
Yeah, they kept it prisoner. They kept taunting me with it, saying they're gonna throw me to it when they were...
What the fuck do I know about an owlbear?
Not much.
They sound dangerous. They sound like a combination of
owls
and
bears. They're big natural creatures that look kind of like bears with owl heads and claws and feathers on them. And they're very vicious.
Hmm.
That's about what you do.
Okay, so... fuck that.
Yeah, we don't want to... I'm just...
let's not mess with an owlbear.
Let's leave. Can we leave? Can we just leave?
Leaving is an option, but let's get to looting first.
We need... Wait, what?
Like, did anyone search this guy?
I said I did, like, 20 minutes ago.
Oh, shoot, you did say you searched him. You find, let's see, most of his like armor and stuff looks like trash, but his belt looks pretty nice, like unusually nice compared to the rest of it.
I take off the belt and put it on.
Zing, no! Dang!
What?
The bar can check that.
It's fine, it can wait.
You don't feel any different.
Zing stares at him. It's not important right now. I just want to grab it and go.
Okay. Well, let's... I'm going to check the two hobgoblins down here, and then we're going to head out.
Roger, let me know.
Those two hobgoblins don't have anything real nice on them. They have 12 silver and 4 gold between them.
Okay.
Sword you can have.
So, can we make it back to the cart?
Yeah, probably.
All right. We try to go back to the cart. Actually, yeah. Kind of going back through the way we came, if possible. Quietly, stealthily.
As you say this, Gundry starts sneezing.
He starts sneezing?
Sneaking.
Oh.
So, our plotted path is to go from...
Is that seeing it?
You see what I'm doing, Chris?
Yes, I see what you're doing.
Obviously noting the bear trap.
I'm gonna get those back.
But the path I took is the way we're getting out of here. Sneaking the whole way.
You did not take...
I did not take what?
Now everybody's out.
Yeah, so...
I have my bear traps.
I need Gundry.
So I guess we took like our hour-long rest, or...
Okay, so once we get on the thing and we're on the way out of here, I'll get the belt identified.
The belt? Well, who's identifying?
Probably Mike.
Well, yeah, Mike would identify. The belt does do something.
What do?
it gives you +2 to your intimidation check.
+2 to my intimidation checks. Okay. Yep. I take off the belt and I actually give it to Lazarus. And I explain what it does.
Makes you seem larger and more intimidating.
Instead of 16-year-old, I seem like a 17-year-old.
You're already really big for a 16-year-old.
Yeah, I am.
I think he'd appreciate that more than me, to be honest. So anyway, I give Lazarus the thing. And then, is that where we want to call it for tonight?
Yeah, it'd probably be good. We don't want to go too far without.
So, there was one other thing. Chris, do you want to just handle that off camera?
You can message me.
I already did. You never responded.
Oh. Is this stuff? Two messages?
Yeah, it's those two messages. Sorry, hello?
The way you wrote it is like you're writing a letter to someone.
I know. I was.
Oh, yeah, you can do that if you want. If that's what you're getting.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
You just have to find someone to post it for you.
Chris. Oh my god.
So, can we take a short rest while we're on the road, since, like, we're all in a wagon?
Oh, yeah, yeah, actually, yes, while you're riding in the wagon, you could be considered having a short rest. With the exception of who's driving.
Definitely not driving.
Gundren says he can drive.
We let Gundren ride.
I'm gonna... Yeah. No, 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 that's not Gundren. That's the other dwarf.
Not Gundren.
I'll give him the reins.
Albert drives it into the ditch.
I clarified, Chris.
I'm also gonna... I am also... Who else is hurt?
Actually, then? At this point, you would not get any response.
Okay, that's fine.
Well, it's better than to not be hurt if we're taking a short rest, so...
Well, yeah.
So, Mike gets all of the health back that he just lost. And Albrecht gets that much.
I'm also hurt, by the way.
I've already used the kit on you.
Okay, I'll just heal myself.
I think it has the Song of Rest.
I like how you're like, heal me, heal me. Oh, you're out of heals? Okay, I'll heal myself.
I had emergency heals, but I'll burn them.
Well, I mean, you can use your, like, hit dice. Instead of, like, your emergency heal.
Oh, yeah, I'll use that, too.
Good job. And you can use as
not bad.
You can use up to like as many as you need.
At this point, a long rest still will only get you back one.
Let me see what Song of Rest does. Actually. Does this song?
My plan was to get down to like basically 5 health, and then just hold that 5 for people to fall down, so I can walk over to them and give them 1 HP to bring them back up.
Oh, if you just spent a hit dice.
Yes.
Oh, wow, we all... If you or any friendly creatures who hear your performance regain hit points. Okay, so anyone who just spent their a hit die gets an extra d6.
What is this so, from?
Mike's Song of Rest.
Is that a spell?
Nope. It's a bard class feature.
Cool. I am back up to full health, and I didn't have to even make a sandwich. That's awesome.
I'm gonna use one.
Oh, yeah. I forgot bards get that.
Okay, I think we're good for today. Anything else we need to be taking note of, I guess? Next week, we're gonna go to Wave Echo Cave.
I believe that's the plan.
Oh my god.
The last dungeon of this adventure.
Yeah, the pre-adventure's almost done. That's crazy.
This is the introductory adventure.
Yeah, that's the crazy part.
Well, the thing is, as far as the next adventure, I only have maybe 20% of it done, and it's already got like 14 encounters or something.
It's nothing but fine.
How far do you think that'll take us in level?
Well, this one should take you to it was 3 or 4. So you might get to level 4 in the cave. It depends on what you guys do and all sorts of other stuff as to whether you get enough to actually get to 4.
Okay.
Hey, Chris.
What?
How much EXP did we get?
Oh, yes.
I'm not keeping track of it. I'm just, whenever you tell me that I can level up, then yeah.
I'm keeping track of it.
Okay, let's...
I'm gonna go to bed. Let me know if you need anything, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so...